Today we will see the transient on the transmission line. So how to find out the value of transmission line, transient on transmission line. So this is a diagram of the transmission line. Resistance and inductance are connected in series across the voltage, and here at this point fault occurs. Okay, so what will be the value of E of t? Value of E of t equal to Em sin omega t, and I of t is equal to Em by Z for this impedance in sin omega t minus phi. Okay, so this phi is the angle of the inductance. We know that the angle of the inductance is given as phi. So we have written here phi angle of the inductance. Okay, now before solving the expression, we have to assume three points, which are assume first that is voltage is constant. Voltage is constant. Second point is short circuit take place in unbalanced condition. What it is said? Short circuit take place in unbalanced condition. Okay. And last point is no capacitance in line. No capacitance is line. Okay. So these three points are important. We have to assume that first is voltage to be constant, and short circuit is occurring in unbalanced condition, and there is a no capacitance in line. Okay. So now at t is equal to t0, fault occurs. Okay. So what will the value? I of t of 0 is equal to Em by Z sin omega t 0 minus phi. Okay, means we have to put the value of t 0 here. So at t is equal to t 0, when fault occurs, I of t 0 equal to Em by Z sin omega t 0 minus alpha. Okay, so this is the point where fault occurs. Now time after fault occur will be, we will write here, time after fault occurs. So what will the value at omega t0 is equal to, we will write here alpha, means initial phase at a time of fault. Initial phase, this is the initial phase at time of fault. Okay, so now we will find the time after fault occurs. This is the value where initial phase at time of fault, okay, where omega t0 is equal to alpha, means we have to write here the value of omega t0, which is alpha. Okay, so now what will the total current? I of t is equal to Is plus It. Okay, so the Is is nothing but the steady state. Okay, this is steady state, and this is I of t is transient current. Transient current. Okay, I of s is a steady state and I of t is a transient current. Okay, so during the fault, transient is produced. This is the important point. When fault occurs, transient current is produced. Okay, So we know that this is an inductive circuit, because here it has resistance and inductance, it is an inductive circuit. So transient current decay at time constant, okay. So as it is, we can write here as it is inductive circuit. Circuit transient current decay at time constant tau is equal to L by R. Okay, this is the value of tau, means time decaying at a time constant, tau is equal to L by R. So I of t is equal to minus Is of 0 e raised to minus R by L of tau. Sorry, t. Okay. So I of t is equal to minus Is 0 plus e raised to minus R by L into t. Okay. So what is the value of Is 0? Is 0 is Am by Z sine alpha minus phi minus alpha, alpha minus phi. So I of t is equal to minus Em by Z sine alpha minus phi e raised to minus R by L into t. Okay. So this will equal to I of t is equal to Em by Z sine phi minus alpha e raised to minus R by L into t. We have we have written the value of phi first, afterward we have written minus phi, so it will be become positive. Okay. Now what will we get? I of t is equal to Em by Z sine omega t plus alpha minus phi plus Em by Z sine phi minus alpha e raised to minus R by L into t. Okay, so this is the total current when fault occurs. So this is known as a symmetrical AC component, and this is known as a DC offset transient current. This is known as a symmetrical AC component, and this is DC offset transient current. Okay. Means due to this time constant, this is a DC offset transient current, and this is a symmetrical AC component. Means I of S plus I of T. Okay, this is the value of this expression. Okay. So we know that Z is equal to under root of R square plus omega L square, and phi is equal to tan inverse omega L by R. Okay. So how we draw the graphical expression? So this is the way to draw the graphical expression. This is the symmetrical AC component. Here it is the alpha, means fault occurring at this, means at this angle, and this is the DC transient component showing by straight graph, and this is the combination of both. Means here you can see that the value at the time of fault, the AC signal is high, means this See, this is the peak value, and afterward it become to steady state value. So at that point, the value of this point is very high. Okay. So now we'll find the maximum momentary current. Means we can say at what point that maximum momentary current. So before solving this, in this diagram, this is the peak value, we know that. So we will neglect this value of current for the short time. Okay, so what we have to find? Maximum momentary short circuit current. Short circuit current. When happened? When at t is equal to 0. Okay, means we have to neglect at this. We have to neglect for some time this value is 0 at t is equal to t0. We have to neglect at t is equal to 0. Means we have to neglect dq of current for the short time. Means first peak. We will write here neglect dq of current in short time. So what will the IMM is equal to EM by mod Z sine phi minus alpha plus EM by Z, where T is equal to 0. So this is the value of maximum momentary current. Suppose if we neglect the resistance, okay, if we neglect resistance, means R equal to 0 and phi equal to 90 degree. Okay, so R equal to 0, this will, so IMM is equal to EM by Z, where sin phi minus alpha means value of phi is equal to 90. So 90 minus alpha is equal to cos alpha plus EM by mod Z. Okay, so this will depend upon the instant of occurring fault. Okay, so if further we solve, if alpha is equal to 0, if alpha is equal to 0, IMM is equal to 2 EM by mod Z. Means when the fault occurs, voltage become 0. When fault occur, voltage will be equal to 0. But normally it is not possible. This is happen in rare case, which is known as a doubling effect. Doubling effect. This happens in the rare case. So normally the value of IMM equal to 1.5 to 1.6 time of EM by Z. Okay, so this is the transient of the transmission line.